Last class we discussed factors for ground settlement. So, in this section, subsoil characteristics one factor, then shape and size and depth, then type and thickness, sorry, type and stiffness. Stiffness of strut, then method of excavation, and of course, last part is your time. Now, if you look at this, these are the factors I have discussed in the last class. What are the factors affected in the ground settlement? Because ground settlement is your prerequisite criteria. As the existing structures are there, so it should not happen that because of ground settlement there will be any settlement in the existing structures. So, it depends upon your subsoil characteristics, but that means, as I said earlier, it is either in soft soil or maybe a firm soil or hard soil. Shape, size and depth of your excavation, how, what is your shape, what is the size and how, what is your depth of your excavation, accordingly the ground settlement also increase or decrease, and type and stiffness of strut, and methods of excavation and time. Now, if you come back to, there are certain case studies in the Calcutta soil. If you look at these case studies in the Calcutta soil, this is settlement delta, and this is your spacing, and this start with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 6. If you look at this experimental investigation before starting of Calcutta Metro Rail, Calcutta Metro Rail is your best example of underground excavation or breast excavation. In this case, this example means there are experimental studies, particularly Calcutta Metro Rail, means beyond a spacing, if you look at here, the diagram is slightly wrong. Beyond spacing greater than 4 meter, if this is my spacing, it is in terms of meter, and settlement delta in terms of mm. Beyond spacing 4 meter, the settlement increases rapidly. There is no such criteria, means ground settlement, there is no such criteria, as I said, shape, size and depth, type and stiffness of your strut, if you look at here, the spacing of the strut for Calcutta Metro, Calcutta soil, if it is increased more than 4 meter, if you look at the initially the settlement range up to 4 meter, it will be negligible, it is kind of a negligible. Beyond 4 meter of your spacing of the strut, the settlement increases very rapidly. This is an experimental investigation, particularly Calcutta Metro Rail. That means, in this case, they have considered your spacing up to 4 meter. That means they have taken up spacing 3 to 4 meter is recommended. The spacing between 3 to 4 meter has been recommended as an optimum spacing. As I said, stiffness of the strut, how, what is the spacing should be there, so that what should be your spacing. If you look at here, these are the struts, these are all your struts, it will hold this particularly wall in vertical position. That means how rigid this strut, it depends upon what is your spacing, what is your spacing between the struts. Now, particularly Calcutta Metro, they found that from experimental investigation, if the spacing has been kept between 3 to 4 meter, then there is a less chance of lateral movement of your wall. These are all case studies, maybe it may vary from this is only for Calcutta soil, Calcutta Metro, for Delhi Metro this will be a different case study. So, these are all depends upon your type and stiffness of the strut, it indirectly depends upon your house spacing. Then come back to next parameter, last one, that is your time. If you look at the time profile for Calcutta Metro, this is time in days, final settlement by initial settlement 30, 60, 90, then 120, 1.2, 1.4, it goes up to say 2.0. If you see, look at this time in days, particularly settlement, it should be, the construction should finish within the 30 days of time. This is based on your case study of Calcutta Metro. If the construction finish within the 30 days of time, that means settlement, less settlement will be encountered, means which settlement I am talking about, ground settlement will be encountered. Everything should finish within the 30 days of time, beyond this the settlement will be more. It may possible for Calcutta soil it is 30 days. It may possible that for Delhi Metro it may be 40-45 days, it is varying from time to time. Before doing this kind of structures, particularly breast excavation, these are the parameter, important parameters you have to study first, then your, based on this important parameter study, then your recommendation will go, then your design will follow. Then it may possible that sometimes what happened, there are during construction, as I am going both to and fro, means top, bottom and back like this, time has gone, then now method of excavation, method of construction, during the construction it may possible that there might be weak joints. While construction, care should be taken, this joint should be leak proof, the joint should not be like it is leaking, it should be leak proof. So, because of these weak joints, what will happen, there will be a leakage of water. So, by leakage of water, once there is a leakage of water will start, what will happen, the entire part will be, it will drag down. That means, if there is a water flowing in this joint, there is a leakage. So, that means, it apply pressure to this wall, once it apply pressure to this wall, that means it will moving out away from this your field. So, there will be a ground settlement. Now, if you look at that at the station, if I go, once you are starting, particularly at the station, these are called joints. This is called steel lugging . If I take this diaphragm wall, what will happen, at station, particularly when you start at the starting point at the station, you need more width, you need more width at the starting point, that means at the station, because how the construction work will start, you need the more width. So, to prevent that more width, you need to have your joints, it should be waterproof. So, there is a chance that at the beginning, maybe at the station point, there will be a leakage, it will start. Once there will be a leakage, will start at the station point. Suppose this is your station point, once there is a leakage will start, what will happen? Because of leakage, this will try to push this wall away from the field. Once wall has been pushed away from the field by means of water pressure, there will be a ground settlement. Then come to next part. This is all about your breast excavation in particularly clay. Now, breast excavation in sand or breast cut. One phenomenon is called piping. If you are doing a breast excavation, particularly a sandy soil, one phenomenon is called piping. What do you mean by piping? In piping, hydraulic gradient, critical hydraulic gradient under which particularly effective stress in sand is equal to 0. Effective stress in sand is equal to 0. That means effective stress is equal to sigma minus u. U is your pore water pressure, sigma is your overburden or vertical stress. So, with this sigma minus u, pore water pressure, effective stress in sand is equal to 0. How it comes? Particularly in case, how the piping will occur? So, you start doing your flow net. From flow net, what will happen? How the drainage will occur? The drainage, generally excavation drainage will start from here to here. So, if I increase this particularly drainage path, this is your initial excavation of your diaphragm wall. With this, this is your flow net. If I increase the drainage path, that means if I increase the drainage path, suppose initially the drainage flow is going from here to here. If I increase the drainage path like this, then what will happen? The critical hydraulic gradient, particularly the effective stress, will not be 0. So, in that case, what supposed to be done? There will be at the bottom, you put some strut so that it will be closed form, and this will act as a cut off wall. That means by increasing this drainage path, the hydraulic gradient will decrease, critical hydraulic gradient will decrease, that means it will be safe. What will happen particularly in this, there if you look at, there are two excavations, I put this wall up to this height. So, after, suppose this is my requirement of this vertical excavation. Beyond this vertical excavation, you extend this wall up to depth, some of the depth. So, what will happen? Instead of the flow is going, if you look at here, the flow is going like this. Look at the drainage path or maybe look at the flow pattern. Here your flow is moving from here to here, it is directly touching your cutting wall, cutting wall. Now, what will happen? I am increasing the drainage path from here. How it is moving? It is going around the periphery, and at the bottom it takes. That means this drainage path, once it has been increased, immediately your hydraulic gradient will decrease, then this will be safe, particularly in case of sand. So, this is, there are two cases, particularly in this case there are two cases, and for Calcutta soils generally it is given by Terjaghi and others. They have given some certain design charts, particularly in sand. We will see case 1 and case 2. Case 1, sand of infinite depth. What does it mean? The sand is infinite depth, that means the depth of the sand will be infinite. So, there is no finite. Below this, the sand will be there up to infinite, say 50 meter, 100 meter, there is no finite depth. Finite depth means 5, 10 or 20 meter. So, in this case, suppose this is my HU, total height of excavation, and this is the depth. Below your height of excavation, below this, this is a depth. So, particularly this case, the design chart has been given. It can be used directly. There are two cases, one is your loose sand, other is your dense sand. So, factor of safety say 1.5 and 2.0, 1.5, 2.0, dense sand also factor of safety say 1.5, factor of safety is equal to 2.0. So, B by HU, what is your B? B is your width of your excavation, HU is your actual depth of excavation. If you remember well, earlier I have discussed, this is my actual depth of excavation. Beyond this depth of excavation, this diaphragm wall has been extended, so that this increase your drainage path. That means, so this is your B by HU, so this is your 0.5 for different B by HU. 0.5, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 1.0, 2.0, 3.0, and this is 4.0. So, this will be coming 1.2, 1.75, 1.0, 3.0, and this is 4.0. So, this will be coming 1.2, 1.75, 1.7, 1.1, 1.5, 0, 0.8, 5, 1.3, for 2 0.9, 1.2 0, 0.6 0, 0.9, 0.8, 1.05, 0.5, 0.75, then 4.0 0, 0.75, 1.04, 0.5 and 0.7. These values, your D by HU. D by HU means this D is unknown, this D is unknown. Beyond this depth of excavation, what should the value of D I should go, so that the critical hydraulic gradient will be less or minimum, so that this in drainage path will be more. So, this D has to be calculated. Based on this experimental investigation, laboratory test, Terjaghi and others, they have proposed this is your design charts for loose sand as well as dense sand, taking factor of safety 1.5, 2.0 and 1.5 and 2.0. So, different value of B by HU. Suppose if I say B by HU is equal to 0.5, that means B value of 0.5, HU of 0.5, 1. So, it is ratio of width to depth, ratio of width to depth. For particularly that ratio of width to depth, suppose you are taking a factor of safety, suppose you are saying that I will provide a factor of safety of 1.5, then what is the value of D by HU? 1.2. So, HU you know. So, D value will be 1.2 times of HU. So, beyond this it has to be extended, so that it should not, piping effect should not occur in this case. Now, case 2, sand of finite depth. Case 1 is your sand of infinite depth. Now, case 2 will be your sand of finite depth. Sand of finite depth means after depth D, there is a sand layer, after depth D, there is a sand layer of H 1, very close to your depth of excavation. That is why it is called sand of finite depth, that is why it is called sand of finite depth. In this case also, they have given certain design charts. These design charts are based on your experimental investigations by Terjaghi et al. Or Terjaghi and others authors, Peck also there. So, based on that this design charts has been arrived. So, if I take it B by HU, suppose say this part I am writing, this part I am writing H 1 by HU, H 1 by HU is equal to 1, then here H 1 by H u is equal to 2, then in this case also H 1 by H u is equal to 1, then H 1 by H u is equal to 2. Now, this is for factor of safety say 1.5 factor of safety, this is for factor of safety say 2.0, and these values are like 0.7, 0.55, let me write all, 0.4, 0.35 and 0.35, 1.1, 0.8, 0.65, 0.45, 0.45, 0.8, 0.75, 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, 1.5, 1.1, 0.65, 0.55, 0.55. Now, these are all values to find it out D by HU. Other cases, if sand of infinite depth, in that case there are two cases consider. One case is your for loose sand and another is your dense sand, but sand of finite depth we have not considered in terms of loose or dense. It has been put it H 1 by H u, H 1 below the depth of excavation, this is the depth of excavation, below this extended depth of your wall, and below this at what depth this sand is there, up to this sand layer is there, H 1 by H u. H is your excavation, depth of excavation, it is 1 or 2, 1 or 2. So, based on that there are different value of B by HU, then you can find it out. Once you know this is given value, B is given, HU is given. Once you know the B by HU value, then one you can decide what value you are supposed to take, h 1 by h u is equal to 1 or h 1 by h u is equal to 2. Why there are two value has been given? Based on these, the other factor of safety has to be checked. As I have discussed with your piping and other, whether it is satisfied with your bottom heave, any possibility, this other factor of safety has to be checked based on this value. Suppose with this h 1 by h u is equal to 1 and b by h u is equal to 0.5, with this you are getting d. With getting this value of d, suppose other factor of safeties are not satisfied, what you are supposed to do? Either increase this value of d, or if you are not increasing, you can take h 1 by h u is equal to 2, then check your other factor of safety. That means, these are the range where this factor of safety, other factor of safety has to be satisfied. So, let us see one typical example before we will go for a complete example how to solve or complete problem of your breast excavation, complete design problem. Now, this is the value of given, say b is equal to 10 meter, h u is equal to 8 meter, and d is value is not given. D, either way, either you choose d value of arbitrary value of d, or check whether this factor of safety is coming within that range or not, or you take that factor of safety, find it out your value of d. So, in this case d has been chosen arbitrarily, and this is your h 1, this is a finite sand of finite depth. So, let us say assume d is equal to 4 meter, and how this d has been assumed? This d has been assumed taking into consideration of less than half h u. If you start assumption of d, then you take the value of d, which should be less than half of h u, less than equal to. If it is 8 meter, so half of h u less than equal to is your 4 meter, so d has been assumed is equal to 4 meter. So, h 1 also, once d has been assumed, this h 1 is equal to, because this total depth is given. So, h 1 also you take it 7.5 meter. So, h 1 by h u, which is equal to 7.5 by 8, approximately it is coming 1. So, from table, h 1 by h u is equal to 1, h 1 by h u is equal to 1, with your b by h u, b by h u is how much it is coming? B is equal to 10 by 8, 1.2, or you can extrapolate the value between 1 and 2, this value extrapolate and find it out what is the value of factor of safety. So, h 1 by h u is equal to 1 and factor of safety I am taking is equal to 1.5. It is generally, normally we take factor of safety of 1.5, then b by h u is equal to 1.25, then from there, once it is 1.25, you find it out value of 1, what is the value of 1, what is the value of 2, how much it is increase, then for 0.25, how much it is increase, then you add it with your 1.25, how this is the way you have to extrapolate this value from this table. So, once you get this, so 1.25, factor of safety is equal to 1.5, then d by h u is equal to d by h u, which is equal to 0.5, that means d is equal to 4 meter. Now, in this case, what will happen? If you look at here, in this case, what is there? I put arbitrarily value of d is equal to 4 meter, means d value should you choose it, there is a thumb rule, less than equal to half of hu, I can take 3 meter, I can take 2 meter. With the assumed value of d, you proceed the calculation and take your factor of safety value of 1.5. With this value of factor of safety 1.5, find the value of d. If d is not coming with this value, whatever the value d is coming, next iteration, suppose here I am taking, the value of d is equal to, let us say, 2 meter. Now, here d value is coming, so 2.5 meter. That means these two are not matching. Then next iteration d you take 2.5 meter calculate. Like this you go, both the d will be approximately, it should be matching, whatever assumed and whatever calculated, then this is your value of d. Once you get the d and draw, then afterwards you draw the flow net and check your other factor of safety, how it is coming, whether it is satisfied or not. We will solve a complete problem in the next class, two problems, next or next to next class. One is for cohesive soil, other is for sand. Thanks a lot.